All right, ladies and gentlemen, welcome to Pulse. This, I tell you right now, promises to be the biggest episode of Pulse that we're going to give you tonight. We got a championship match, and we got something to announce regarding that championship match a little bit later. But we're going to start off right now with the main man, Otto. Otto's on a roll, according to him, lately. We saw him a couple weeks ago against Eric Campbell, and his promise was definitely achieved. He didn't win the match. Eric Campbell managed to come up successful in that one, but Otto impressed some people. He took it to Eric Campbell. Eric Campbell did not know what hit him. Otto put him through the announce table. He kept up the pressure on there. It was just his ego that got in the way that really prevented him from winning. So let's see if he can take it to his opponent tonight. It's going to be a tough one if Otto wants to keep his role going, but he says he does want to keep his role going. So if anything, if that match against Eric Campbell was any indication, we might be in for a treat. But right now, he's fighting Ivan Yakov, who did come off a couple weeks ago also, his first win here, beating Myers Posey in a hard-hitting match, a battle of the two bulls, and Ivan managed to come out on top, got the win. He's a resilient person, no doubt about it, and I'm pretty sure on any other week I would say he's definitely resilient enough to beat Otto, but anything's possible in CME. And I'd like to right off the bat say, Tucker's not here tonight, that's why you do not hear his glorious voice blessing your ear holes. He is out right now scouting some more talent, because honestly the GM's really not doing too good in that department. We're gonna have to deal with the GM in a little bit. I'll reference that a little bit more later, but we'll get to that. Tucker's not here. Otto is gonna start the match. Ivan has no idea that Otto's in the ring. Yeah, he turned right around into Otto. Otto, my God, Otto just blew snot in his face. Not exactly what Ivan wanted. Clotheslines him into the corner. This is not starting off the way Otto probably wanted to start off, but he probably should have attacked him instead of blowing snot in the man's face. And Ivan saw it coming. He knew Otto was behind him doing whatever he was doing. Oh, a nice double hammer right there. Right, just knocking Otto right down to the ground. Otto's going to have to try and get back in this soon. He's trying to run away. Oh, Ivan with a nice... It looked like he went for a clothesline, but caught him with his fist to the face instead. Now he dumps Otto out of the ring. This is Ivan's ring right now. Ivan's in command. Otto's out for a strange amount of time right now. It's still early on. It took him a while to get up from that. See if the ref might count him out. Is Otto going to get counted out here? He's pandering to the fans over there. I don't even know what to call that. Oh, Ivan was doing something of his own. Otto gets back in the ring with a nice punch to the chest, but Ivan gets him down immediately right after that. Oh, Ivan dumps Otto out of the ring again. I think this might be Ivan's way of saying this is his ring. You have no business in here with me, Otto. Otto is just... Somebody's taking a picture of Otto on his back right out there. That's a little bit disrespectful, but then again, it is Otto. We got a three count, I believe. Otto's trying to get up to the top rope, and he's immediately caught by Ivan. I have no idea what was on Otto's mind right there. He gets stomped for good measure. I think Ivan's just going to have fun with this one. Ivan picking Otto up to his feet now. Oh, Otto gets down to the ground. Nice fireman's carry counter. Can he get some momentum going? And no, he chooses to just do what he does best. And he gets dumped right out of the ring again for it. This is a commanding performance from Ivan. He doesn't even have to attack Otto. He just has to keep throwing him out of the ring. Now, Otto did say he wants to keep his hot streak going. Now, I don't know what constitutes a hot streak to Otto, because he didn't win, but he definitely has a fire underneath him. And Otto's clear. He's going for the chairs. He's clearing at that timekeeper's table. Ivan's right behind him, though, to stop him. Ivan with a punch to the back. Oh, and then a nice uppercut. Oh, Otto swings it away, though. These guys are going to get counted out, or Otto might get disqualified if he wants to hit him with a chair. Oh, a nice chop knocking Ivan down. The ref is still counting. Otto's got a chair. Oh, come on, not this way. Otto hits him with a chair. Otto just gets disqualified. All right, that's not a hot streak. Get the camera off, and we got something from Joe Crusoe.
You see, I put you through a table, Seraph. I've already beaten you. Yet now... beaten by you in a number one contenders match. You shouldn't have even been there. It was not your place. I've already beaten you.
We're back. We had to control some situation with Otto after that match. Otto just lost his damn mind and decided to hit him with a chair because he couldn't beat Ivan. But you just heard Joe Crusoe. Here's Ellis Mason coming to the ring, by the way. Joe Crusoe feels like... And you know what? He does have a point. He has beaten Seraph before. He beat him in that hellacious tables match at Resolution. And he thought he deserved the title match. He shouldn't have had to been in the number one contenders match. So the general manager, I don't know, he didn't want to change the match because legally, Seraph is contractually obligated, since he won, to get a championship match. So Joe Crusoe is going to have to earn his way into the title match tonight. We have a big announcement for you. First time you're going to hear about it right now. Coming up next, as a matter of fact, after this match, We've got Joe Crusoe. He's going to have to fight Seraph's tag team partner, Damien. And these two are no strangers to each other, obviously. Joe Crusoe versus Damien, the winner of that match, will be added to the main event for the CME World Heavyweight Championship in a triple threat. So this could go two very, very different ways. Instead of Seraph, Jackson, Montgomery one-on-one, we might have a triple threat. But right now, here comes Corporal Punishment. Corporal Punishment is going to be fighting Pierce at the Crash Course pay-per-view. And we have some words on what that match is going to be. Take it away. Here's from Corporal Punishment from earlier.
Because of your disrespect of me in this country, I've talked to the GM and given me the choice of the match you lose in. And I can think of none better than a Corporal War match. Buckle up, Buttercup.
That was from earlier. Like I said, I give the GM a little bit of credit for making a good decision and adding the Joe Crusoe-Damien match to see who fights for the title later tonight in the triple threat. I don't agree with the GM right here. I am technically in charge of the GM, so we're going to have another conversation. We've had some conferences before, but there is absolutely no way that Corporal Punishment should have lobbied or had the power to lobby for his own kind of match. But we do have rules for you. I was curious as to what a Corporal Law match is. We'll get into that during this match. We got Corporal Punishment. We got Ellis Mason. This should be a hard-hitting match. Let's go. Corporal Law match, apparently, according to what I understand about it. Now, Pierce is at a severe disadvantage because Corporal Law means Corporal Punishment has a no-holds-barred, no disqualification, anything-goes match. Corporal Punishment can do whatever he wants. Pierce, as a matter of fact, cannot. Pierce is bound by the rules, obviously, but Corporal Punishment can do whatever he wants, which is severely unbalanced, and I don't understand exactly where the GM's coming from here, but let's get to this match. That's in a couple weeks, Crash Course. We'll get to it when we get to it. Pierce obviously cannot be happy about it. We'll probably hear from him in a little bit, maybe next week. I don't know what Pierce is doing right now, but we got Ellis Mason, Corporal Punishment. If Ellis Mason wins this match, you know he's got to bump his standing up a little bit, because Corporal Punishment is in a pay-per-view match, and as of right now, Ellis Mason is not. If Ellis Mason can give a good showing right here, he might have the pay-per-view match on his hands, too. Let's see. But Corporal Punishment's got him in a claw, almost like a Von Erich-style claw right here. He's got Ellis Mason down to the ground. Ellis has got to get out of this claw. Is he going to do it? Well, Corporal Punishment decides to let go of the claw. Ellis was right there by the ropes. He could have probably reached it. Corporal Punishment gets off and tries to keep the punishment going. No pun intended. But Ellis Mason reverses him, hip tosses him back over the ropes into the ring from the apron. And now we got Ellis going to the top rope. Somebody has a sign in the crowd that says D'Lo Brown rules. Well, I agree, son, but that was about 15 years ago. Nice fist drop from the top row from Ellis. We got a cover. We got one. Well, almost a two count. We got a one count from the ref there, and Ellis Mason trying to keep the pressure on early. I like this. Nice right hand. Oh, missed the drop kick, though. Punishment moves. Punishment goes to rebound off the ropes. Does not, though, but hits him with the back elbow. Nice chop. Nice punch to the gut. A couple punches. Oh, and then a nice double chop to the ears. And a straight jab to knock him down. That was a great series of strikes from Punishment. You can't take anything away from Punishment, despite what you might feel about the rules to his match against Pierce. He's a hell of a wrestler. Oh, but he misses the elbow drop from the top rope. We got a cover from Ellis. We got a one. Oh, almost a two count again. Ellis tried to take advantage of the mistake from Corporal Punishment. That's smart strategy. Now we got an Irish whip in the corner here. Oh, Ellis with a kick to the gut. Props himself on the second rope. Oh, nice sunset flip from Ellis Mason into a pin. What do we got? We got a one. We got a two. Oh, this could be... almost a three count. Ellis Mason almost had Corporal Punishment down for the count. Punishment's really got to get back in this match. He started off strong, but Ellis is taking the advantage right now. Oh, Punishment drops down. Nice jawbreaker counter. Can he get some momentum here? Good clothesline from Corporal Punishment. He's picking Ellis Mason up to his feet now. Uh-oh. Oh, is he going to do that double underhook we've seen so far from him? He's got him up in the air. Yes! Corporal Punishment hits the double underhook suplex. He's going for a cover of his own. We got a one. We got a two. Oh, just kicked out at two. Ellis Mason almost got put down for the count. Punishment is not happy with the ref. Oh, Ellis is getting to his feet now, though. Surprised to see that double underhook so early. Oh, nice headbutt. Corporal Punishment, we've said it before, he's got a head of steel. That headbutt is no joke. Oh, Ellis drops down to a nice fireman's carry. Ellis, nice Irish whip to the corner. Oh, went for a running uppercut in the corner, but missed. Uh-oh, Punishment's got Ellis up. Is he going to hit it? Oh, he hit the Freedom Bomb. Corporal Punishment hits the Freedom Bomb on Ellis Mason. This could be it. He's surveying the situation. Is he going to go for the cover? Yes, he is. We got a one, two, and a three. Corporal Punishment wins against Ellis Mason. It was a fast-paced match. Give Ellis Mason credit. He did have some of the good offense right there in the middle part, but Corporal Punishment got the momentum by the end and did not rescind. He kept the punishment. Once again, no pun intended. It's hard to keep saying that word and not mean his name. But Punishment gets the win here against Ellis Mason, just further building more momentum for his match against Pierce at Crash Course. Pierce is gonna have to try and get some momentum of his own. He's not got a match tonight. We'll see how it goes next week, but Punishment is really racking up the wins. He's racking up the momentum, and he has beaten Pierce. The last time Pierce and Punishment were in the ring, Punishment came out on top, so Pierce is not looking too strong going into the show, and you gotta think that, especially with that corporal loss stipulation we got going on, he's not gonna be, he's definitely not got the advantage, but he's not gonna be happy. It might weigh on his mind. We'll have to see how it goes, but it was a good win for Corporal Punishment over Ellis Mason. Ellis Mason was game tonight, no doubt about it, but Punishment just proved to be too strong. As we see some of the highlights here, it was a nice double underhook. After that, it was all academic almost. But up next, like I said, Joe Crusoe is going to be fighting Damien, and the winner will be added to the main event later tonight. And then there's not going to be much of a rest in between for these guys, so whoever wins is only going to have a minuscule amount of time to get ready for the main event. It's definitely a disadvantage. Both of these guys want their championship match, so they're going to get it. One of them is going to get it tonight. You can see Punishment celebrating in the ring right now, just trying to intimidate the ref. I don't know what people have against the referee in this company, but a lot of people aren't happy, Tucker included. If Tucker was here, he'd probably be cursing out the ref for some of the counts he made earlier. All right, we are back, and we got a huge match for you. You thought the championship main event's huge, and believe me, it is. We got another main event caliber match. Damien versus Joe Crusoe. These two, once I said before, no strangers to each other. They fought each other before. Joe Crusoe's run in many times before trying to attack Damien and Seraph. But they did have a one-on-one match. It was the night before, the Pulse before Resolution. Joe Crusoe fought Damien, and come on! Why do I not even expect it at this point? Joe Crusoe is running out behind Damien. Nice boot to the face. Lays him out on the rampway. We're going to get this started right away. Why not? Nice elbows to the head. But like I was saying, Joe Crusoe and Damien had a hell of a match in the semifinals for the CME World Heavyweight Championship Tournament. Some would say Joe got screwed. Joe would certainly say he got screwed. And to be fair, he did. Damien used a sledgehammer, used the exposed turnbuckle, and Joe went down for the count. But Joe's going to be out for revenge here, pretty much. It's simple as that. That's all he wants to do right now. Joe Crusoe just throwing Damien into the barricade. These guys are working their way down to the ring, and Joe has clearly got the distinct advantage after sneaking in here and booting Damien in the face on the ramp. Now Joe's just beating him down, throwing him on the ground, stomping him. Is he going to get him back in the ring? Yes, he is. He throws Damien into the ring. Ooh, an elbow right to the nose. That's got to be a killer. Joe's going to the top rope. This bell has not officially rung yet since Joe's not in the ring, but now he is. Elbow drops from the top rope. Ring the bell. We got this match finally officially starting after Damien took a huge beating on the ramp on the way to the ring. Nice knee to the back from Joe. Joe's telling Damien to get up. This is exactly, you know, agree with it or not, this is exactly what Joe needed. He needed to come out of the gate strong and get going here. And he got him with a nice drop kick to the ribs. But Damien's back up. Clotheslines Joe down with a clothesline to the back of the head. He's going to pin him right now. We got not a one count. Joe managed to push him out just before the one count. Still early, but you got to think Damien wanted to end this as fast as possible after a start like that. Nice wrestling takedown from Damien. Oh, Damien's sliding to the outside of the ring. What has Damien got in mind here? I think he's just trying to regroup. He needs to get his bearings with him and try and get back in here, because he did take a lot of beating in the... Oh, nice! Joe was telling him to get back in the ring. Damien obliged with a nice springboard dropkick. We got a cover. We got a one. Oh, just a one count. Joe managed to get out right before the two. It's progress. He got a one count on him with a nice dropkick and a nice discus elbow right to the head of Joe. This, I have a feeling, is going to be very much a back-and-forth match the way it's going. Oh, Joe with counters the scoop slam into a back suplex of his own. Very nice counter from Joe Crusoe. Now he's just stomping him on the ground. Joe Crusoe is just filled with anger. If you've watched any episodes of Pulse before, you know this. Uh-oh. Ooh, nice side belly-to-belly from Joe. This is looking like Crusoe's match early on, even though Damien did get some offense. He's going to have to keep the momentum going if he wants to slow down Joe. Oh, but that might slow him down on his own accord and miss the fist drop from the top rope. Damien's going to try to capitalize again. We got a one. We got a two. Oh, he just got out after missing the fist drop. That could break your hand, ladies and gentlemen, but Joe Crusoe managed to get his shoulder up just before the three count. You got to think he was feeling the effects of it. And Damien's not happy about it, because certainly he wants to get out of this as fast as possible. Both of these guys, as a matter of fact, want to get out of this as fast as possible. Oh, no! Oh, my God! Damian went for a springboard corkscrew 450 splash to the outside, and Joe managed to move just out of the way. Joe has got him up in a military press. Are we going to see the uppercut? Yes, we are. The uppercut from Joe Crusoe on the outside. Not going to be the winner, though, unless he can get him in the ring and pin him. He can win by countout. It would still count. But Joe, oh, he hits the elbow drop from the top rope to the outside. This man has absolutely no fear, no qualms about anything. He will do whatever it takes to win. And he's got him in a sleeper hold. He's going to try to make the man pass out. I know you cannot tap out on the outside of the ring, but if he can make him pass out on the outside of the ring, he can certainly get in there and get a count out win. Oh, nice. Arm wrench into a clothesline from Joe Crusoe. And Joe is a little bit tired, it looks like, just from the beating he's been laying in on Damian. But like I was saying, these guys want to end this as soon as they possibly can, because you got to keep as much energy, as much stamina as you can for the main event, because it's not far away. If it was next week, I could see maybe having a long match would be okay as Damian trips up Joe on the apron. But right now, they got to make sure they get the job done as soon as possible. Oh, Damian went for a nice splash from the apron, missed, and Joe caught him with a big boot. Joe, oh, going for another sleeper hold on the outside. Damian is not looking good. I think Joe just is going to try anything he can, whether he can win by countout or get Damian disqualified or anything. He's going to try and do it because this guy wants his title shot. He feels like he is entitled to a title shot, does Joe Crusoe. And you got to sympathize with the guy. Essentially, he's been screwed out of the title before, or a title shot at least. So now he gets a fair shot. Maybe to him, he feels like he should have just been inserted automatically, but now he can earn his way into the title match later tonight. These guys are still on the outside, by the way. They got to break the count, and they are going back in the ring right now. Damian tried to catch Joe on the way in. Joe managed to counter it. Gets him with a kick to the gut and a punch to the face. Oh, nice drop kick. But Damian is still on his feet. He's withstanding these blows from Joe Crusoe. Uh-oh. Oh, Joe's got him in a sleeper in the middle of the ring now. Can Damian manage to get out of it? Oh, Joe pushes him off, though. Oh, and Damian runs right back at him after the push-off with the drop kick. He goes for the cover. We got a one. We got it. Ooh, almost a two count. Joe gets the shoulder up, and Damian is not happy right now. He wants to put this man away at all, like, with anything, and he cannot manage to get him down. Damian is calling for something. He's playing to the crowd. He gets kicked in the ribs for it. Oh, nice chop from Damian into a beautiful drop kick to the head. Damian off the ropes. Beautiful jump and clothesline from Damian. He's picking Joe up now. Oh, we've seen this before. This is a reverse Boston Crab from Damian. Is he going to make Joe tap out in the middle of the ring? We see him do this mostly on the outside just to keep the legs hurt, but no, Joe will not tap out, and Damian wants to keep the pressure on him as much as he can. Kicks him in the back, though, and he's going for the pin after that submission. We got a one. Oh, just a one count again. Joe Crusoe is... You see the look on Damian's face. That's the look of pure anger. And Joe Crusoe is kicking out and managing to stay up as much as he can. Damian misses the dropkick. Joe dropkicks Damian, but Damian's head collides with the ref. The ref is thankfully getting to his feet, though, so he's not out of action too long. Give the ref credit. He certainly is resilient. Damian is now crawling to the ropes to try and get up. He counters, though, rolls out of the way. Uh-oh. Oh, Joe's got Damian. Oh, beautiful. A reverse face crusher, and Damian's face collided with the second turnbuckle right there. If only Joe wanted to get some revenge and have that turnbuckle exposed, Damian would have been split wide open. Oh, no, Joe smashing Damian's knee into the mat, telling him to get up after the fact, just rubbing it in. And Joe is... It's looking like this is Joe's match so far. Damian claps the ears, tosses him over. Damian's got to get some extended time in control because Joe has managed to keep the pressure on this whole time. And Damian, is he going for that reverse Boston again? Joe is right by the ropes, though. Joe's hand is under the ropes. The ref's got to break this. The ref sees it, though. He didn't break it. I guess Joe didn't have his hand right under the rope. I thought he did. Uh-oh. Joe is hurt, though. Despite getting released from the hold, he is just writhing on the ground, and Damian's on the top rope. I think he's measuring his man. Is he waiting for Joe to get up? Oh, he went for the double stomp, but Joe rolled out of the way. Oh, and get caught with a knee to the head. This Damian, my goodness, gets put back on the ground. Just when you think he's going to get the ball rolling and get things on his side again, he immediately gets put back down by Joe. This is looking more and more like Joe's match. Oh, no, we just saw this. Not again. Oh, Joe with another reverse face crusher right in the second turnbuckle again, and that was a lot of velocity on that one. If Damian didn't have a concussion before, he might have one now. Oh, and he might have one after this, for sure, if he hits this. He's going for that military drop uppercut, and he hits it. You got to go for the cover, Joe. Don't go for the punishment. You got to go for the win. He's telling him to get up to his feet. Joe, just, I don't know, he just wants to punish him at this point, but he does, you know, you got to think in the long term right here. You can't just think about revenge, because you know he wants revenge. And there you go, Damian claps the ears, throws him over again, manages to counter it. I know Joe doesn't like the order, I know he wants revenge, but you got to start thinking about your title match. Oh, beautiful leg drop from the top rope from Damian. I think Damian is the more focused of the two, and this could, oh, Damian's going to the top rope again after hitting that leg drop. What is he going to do this time? Oh, he hits the double stomp this time. Is he going to go for the cover here? No, he's not. He's getting Joe to his feet. Beautiful uppercut from Damian. Oh, we got an Irish whip now. Drop down. Oh, missed the dropkick, though. Joe managed to get out of the way of the dropkick, and now stomps him down. Just think of how different the main event is going to be depending on who wins this match. Because there is no interference. Nice arm drag counter by Damian, by the way. There is no interference in this match. No one, Jackson or Seraph, are allowed to interfere. And there's no interference in the main event. The GM has made that especially clear, thankfully. So if Damian wins this match, you got Damian and Seraph. They're going to work together and try and take the title from Jackson, no matter who wins, I think. Oh, my gosh. Joe went for the fist drop from the top rope and missed. If that didn't break his hand when he did it in the ring, that could do it right there. He hit the mat with his bare fist, and he is down, but he's climbing up to his feet just somehow. Oh, my God. Damian with a straight jump to the top rope into a corkscrew plancha. My goodness. These two guys are going all out right now, and this is for the title shot. This is not even for the title. This is for a shot at the title. That's how much it means to these guys. If Joe Caruso managed to win this match, though, like I said, I don't know if the alliance between him and Jackson, although they do have an alliance, I don't know if it's going to mean as much, because you know Joe just wants that title with any means necessary. Alliance or no alliance, friends or no friends, he's going to go after Jackson just as much as he would go after Seraph. I feel like they might obviously both be looking out for each other, but when the title's in the line, and Damian missed an elbow drop to the outside, these two are just going all out, trying to hit any kind of move they can, and it's paying off or it's not. It just depends on what they do, but it hasn't been paying off for these guys lately. And Joe throws Damian ribs first into those stairs. The edges of those stairs are hard. That can cut you open. And the ref is counting now. Joe gets in the ring. I think he might be just going for a count-out win at this point. We got a five, but Damian's up to his feet. Damian's on the apron now. Oh, Joe was going right after Damian, hits him with a dropkick, and knocks the ref down in the process. No one can stand in this man's way when he's got his heart set on revenge. Oh my God, even if Joe goes for the pin here, hits him with a nice elbow drop, the ref is still down. Surprisingly, the ref got up with a head-to-head collision, but that one, he did not see that one coming at all, and he got knocked down right on his face. Oh, Damian rolls out of the ring just to get back in here. Ooh, a beautiful springboard roundhouse kick from Damian, knocking Joe right down to the ground. My goodness. And now we're back at square one. These two are both down. And now they're both getting up. Oh, but Damian's going to the top rope here. Joe just knocks his legs out from underneath him, knocks Damian off the top rope, and now he's going to the top rope of his own. Just tit for tat. What I can do, what you can do, I can do better. And Joe misses the crossbody from the top rope, and now Damian is going back to the top rope. My goodness, one of these guys have got to hit something. Is it going to be Damian here? Oh, beautiful 450 splash from the top rope from Damian. Is he going to try to end it? No, he's not. He's getting him up to his feet, though. What does he have in mind? Oh, he's got Joe to his feet, and he's taking off that turnbuckle. He's exposing the steel underneath the turnbuckle. Tried to throw Joe into it. Joe counters it. Oh, and Joe throws Damian. Oh, back first into the exposed steel underneath the turnbuckle. Damian is just writhing in pain on the ground as Joe gets him up. He's going to go for it. This is the third uppercut. Is Joe going to manage to hit it this time? Boom! He hits it right in the mouth. That's, his teeth have got to be loose after three of those. My goodness. And Joe hits the rise and fall on Damian. We got to see a replay of that. That is the rise and fall. This has got to be it, Joe. You got to go for the cover, man. Oh, but Joe's slow to get to his feet right now. He's just getting up to his feet now. Is he going to... He's not going for the cover. What is he doing? This could be a mistake for Joe Caruso. This really could be a mistake. He's dragging... Oh, he drags Damian into the corner right there. What is he doing? He's setting something up. He's lifting Damian onto the top rope. Damian is seated on the top turnbuckle, and he kicks Joe right in the face. Not going to work for the way Joe wanted. Beautiful double leg missile drop kick from Damian. Joe could have gone for the cover after the rise and fall. I don't know if it would have ended it or if it would have kept going, but he certainly could have tried as Damian gets Joe up to his feet now. Oh, no. He hits him with that brainbuster DDT that he calls the all falls down. Damian hits the all falls down on Joe Caruso, and if he is smart, he is going to not make the same mistake Joe did. He's going for the cover. This very well could be it. We got a one. We got a two. Oh my God, Joe Crusoe kicked out of the All Falls Down. This man cannot be stopped, and Damian's got to be wondering what he has to do to keep him down on the mat for three. And Joe Crusoe back to his feet with a look at the momentum he got behind that clothesline, knocking Damian right back down. Joe is telling him to get up. How is he not feeling the effects of the All Falls Down? You got to think he's feeling it. He's running on adrenaline right now. So is Damian. He's getting up to his feet. Who is going to be added to the world title match? Joe Crusoe lifts him up as high as he can in the air. Did you see how high he went? This is all for a title shot for the World Heavyweight Championship. Oh, Joe is going to pick Damian up. Damian is with the leg screw. I don't know who's gonna go in now for this match. These two are taking it to each other. They're tearing each other limb from limb, and this is amazing. Joe dumps Damian out of the ring now. At this point, you know, any kind of win is a good win if you're Joe Crusoe or if you're Damian. Joe is going to follow him right now on the outside. Oh, and hits him with a nice elbow drop just for good measure. Keep him down there. Oh, Damian getting up, though. Saw the stomp coming. Joe tried to get back in the ring. Damian caught him back. Suplex right on the outside. Right on those thin, thin mats we have. Oh, but Joe throws Damian back in the ring as they both got up to their feet. Another elbow drop. We saw that earlier. It feels like a half hour ago we saw that when Joe Crusoe ambushed Damian on the ramp. Oh, no. Joe's got Damian up. Oh, he's got him in an Irish whip right now. Oh, they both collide head first. Who's going to get the advantage here? Joe seems to get it. He's got a nice takedown. Nice wrestling takedown from Joe Crusoe. Keeping Damian on the mat. That's the way to go if you're Joe. Now he's getting Damian up. He's got him in a sleeper hold. We saw this a couple of times earlier, but he's pushing him off now. Damian is still safe in this matchup. Oh, Damian gets Irish whipped into the corner, chest first. Now just imagine, he's got him in another sleeper hold. But Damian is right by the ropes. The ref tells him to break it. Uh-oh, Damian running right at him and hits him with a nice drop kick right to the knees. Oh, and a kick to the gut from Damian. This is just back and forth. And like I said, back and forth jawbreaker from Joe getting out of that move. Damian running at Joe, going for a clothesline. Joe manages to body up and block it. Now he's got some body shots. Missed the dropkick, though. Damian with an elbow, and Damian with a dropkick to the knee. Right now, Joe is precariously placed on the apron. Oh, no. What is he going for? Oh, he hangs Joe up in a front suplex on the top rope. My goodness. Remember, that turnbuckle is still exposed. Damian, oh, Irish whips Joe back first into the steel. What's good for the goose is good for the gander. Joe feels how it felt, even though he did feel how it felt weeks ago when these two first fought. And Damian is going to the top rope here. Joe is placed. Oh, Joe is trying to struggle to his feet. How is he doing this? Oh, Damian hits him with another nice double leg missile drop kick, though. My gosh, going for the cover on Joe. We got a one. Oh, he kicks out. He gets the shoulder of it just barely as he counts two. Damian, we've seen that face many times, and that's the face I'm making right now. I can't believe these two are still going at it. I cannot believe it. Oh, Damian missed a nice uppercut, though. Joe missed his uppercut, but hits a straight right and a nice dropkick. But Damian is still on his feet. He is not knocked down, and Joe's going for more strikes, more punches. We're seeing a lot of the brawling side of Joe, and Damian is still eating these blows. How is he doing it? Oh, but he's not going to eat that. Clothesline to the back of the head from Joker. So finally puts Damian down. My goodness, these two are just going. This is a war. This is a flat-out war. Nice dropkick. Oh, Joe almost got hung up on the top rope, but he is okay. He's good. He's telling Damian to get up now. Damian looks out on his feet, though. Joe sees it. He's going for the cover. We got a one. We got a two. Oh, Damian just gets the shoulder up. That was almost a three count. Joe wants the three count, but the ref said it was a two. It was a two. Just barely, though. Uh-oh, Joe's measuring something. Uh-oh, Damian ran at him. Oh, no. This is the fourth time. If he isn't missing any teeth right now, he's got to be missing if he hits this. Boom. A straight uppercut. Are you kidding me? Wow. Uh-oh, Joe's got him to his feet. Gets him in a sleeper hold. Pushes him off, though. I feel like he's just doing this as a mental game right now. And yes, he is. He hits him at the rise and fall after pushing him out of the sleeper. Joe is just getting in the head with those sleeper holds. At first, I thought he was trying to get him out cold to knock him down, but he's just showing Damian that he is in control of this matchup. And he hits him with the rise and fall, and that's not enough for Joe Crusoe. He is not going for the pants or the rise and fall. He hits another rise and fall. That's the third one we've seen in this match. My goodness, and he almost put him through the ring with that one. My God, the velocity and the whiplash of Damian's head. And Joe is not going for the pin. What is he doing? He's trying to brutalize this man. A third rise and fall from Joe Crusoe. Oh my God, that's the third one in a row. Joe, you got to go for the pin here. You've made your point. Pin the man. There you go. Joe Crusoe is going for the pin. We got a new champion. Damian was underneath the ropes. Joe Crusoe cannot believe it. The ref didn't even have to count because Damian's hand was underneath the rope. Damian didn't even know where he was in the ring, and he gets him with a dropkick now. You got to think that if the ref did not see Damian under the ropes, that would have been a three count. But Damian's body was perfectly placed to where this match is still going on. And Joe, you got to think, should have pinned him after the first one. The Joker so has gotten Damian down. Damian has no idea where he is after three rise and falls. Nice slingshot maneuver. You got to think this match is all academic at this point because Damian is out like a light right now. Oh no, what do we got here? Uh-oh, Joe is now carrying Damian, throwing him into the corner. What is he going to do? He's measuring something here. Oh no, is he going to go for that lawn dart? This has got to be it if he hits it. Oh, he lawn darts him face first into the second turnbuckle. That's multiple times now. We've seen Damian's face collide with that second turnbuckle. And Joe, this has got to be it if he hits this. He's looking to end it right now. We may have our number one contender right here. Oh, no, he's going for that Koji clutch. He's going to make him tap out. He's got Damian in the Koji clutch. Damian can see the ropes, but he cannot reach the ropes. Is this going to be a tap out? He's got him in. Damian is trying to hang on. Damian taps out. What a war we just saw between two guys fighting for a shot at the greatest prize in our sport. And Joe Crusoe, more power to him, gets what he had coming to him. Especially in his mind, he believed he had it coming to him. That was a hell of a match we just saw between Damian and Joe Crusoe. And you got to think we're going to see more wars between these two, between The Order and Jackson Montgomery and Joe Crusoe. They're fighting at the Crash Course pay-per-view in a tag team match. But that's why we have the title match tonight. We cannot have the champion not defend his title at least every 30 days. So we are going to have what should be a pay-per-view main event, the Crash Course main event. Very well could be. We're going to have it for you on Pulse tonight, and very shortly, as a matter of fact. These two, well, Joe Crusoe, I should say, since he won the match, is not going to have much rest time at all. We have one more match for you in between. After the next match, we got that title match for you. You got to stay buckled in because it's coming soon. But we're seeing some highlights right here of this just classic battle. Once Joe Crusoe, you got to think, once he hit that first rise and fall, you know, in the succession of three that he hit, even though, look, we'll see it right here, Damian was under the ropes. The ref saw it and saw his hand was right there by the rope. Damian didn't even grab the rope, but if your hand is underneath the rope, that's still a rope break. You cannot pin the man when they're out there. But we just saw he got Damian to tap out, and that's got to feel damn good for Joe Crusoe to make the man tap out. These two do not like each other, and making somebody tap out is probably the greatest feeling you can have as an in-ring competitor. Not that I would know, but you got to think. But we'll take a quick break. We got more to come. Here we are again, ladies and gentlemen. We got a little few seconds to catch our breath right there, but we're going to go right back into the action with, here they come, the tag team champions, the tag team police department. Officer Tex on the right, Officer Avery on the left are the CME tag team champions. And they are, I don't even want to say who they're fighting, but you'll probably know by my tone of voice. But the TTPD are not happy. They're very vocally not happy that the match is made official. At Crash Course, the Tag Team Police Department will be defending their tag team championships against Jake Parker and Tiburon, a.k.a. Air Force. Air Force have been lobbying for that tag team title shot for weeks. They feel like ever since that, they technically did win that match in the tag team title tournament, but they gave up their title shot, and that's on them. But the Tag Team Police Department certainly did not want to give them another title shot, despite having full command of that match. They do not want to face Air Force again. The general manager, after weeks of badgering, finally granted Air Force their title shot. So we're going to see that match at Crash Course, and I personally can't wait. And here comes the Tag Team Police Department's opponents for tonight, the Gimps, who once again have a match on Pulse, despite having absolutely no potential whatsoever to win a match. And especially against the Tag Team Champions, I don't know how well they're going to fare tonight. But you never know, anything is possible in the world of professional wrestling. So the Gimps are coming down to the ring. They did not wrestle in last week's show. If you remember, last week's show was all about the absolute destruction, I should say. We did have the Sarah vs. Joker show match to decide the number one contender for tonight. But then we had about a 40-minute match between two guys who absolutely hate each other, George Knox and Ranch Wilder. We can say for sure, if you were curious, not that I am, because I honestly don't want to see it again, But George Knox and Rance Wilder were released from the hospital 24 hours after that match, despite absolutely destroying each other's lives. And we got one more match coming for you between those two. They're going to fight at Crash Course again. The general manager decided to grant them the match. Unsanctioned again, by the way, so we're not legally liable for whatever happens. It's going to be a last man standing match at Crash Course between Knox and Wilder. Hopefully, it's the last match between Knox and Wilder. And Avery hits Adam with a running clothesline. Oh, Avery was going something to do something, but Steve just jabbed Avery in the head. Avery's out on his feet. Oh, and that's what Steve gets for that. Avery knocks him right off the apron. And Adam is trying to struggle to his feet after that clothesline. And what is he? Oh my God, look at the strength! A reverse suplex on Gimp Adam from Officer Avery. Avery just knocks Steve off the apron for good measure again. And Avery's going for a pin. We got a one, two, we got a three! The Tag Team Police Department win in near record time, I believe. I think that might be the fastest match we've ever had on CME Pulse. We're going to have to check the record books, but I'm pretty confident when I say that. Wow, was that like a 25-second match? The Tag Team Champions surely showed what they're capable of, although against the Gimps, I guess anything is possible. You can really beat them pretty easily. But wow, 25 seconds about it. I have to check the official time from the timekeeper, but that was a quick match for the Tag Team Police Department. If that's a message to the Air Force better watch out, because they're going to come up against some stiff competition if they want those tag team titles from the TTPD. That's all I'm going to say about that. And TTPD are fired up like they just won the titles for the first time. But you got to think, it builds momentum. If anything else, the Tag Team Police Department are going into Crash Course with some good wins under their belts. They did beat the champion, Jackson Montgomery, in a six-man a couple of weeks ago. So they're looking confident. They're looking good. The Tag Team Police Department are going to be going up against Air Force, like I said. But right now, coming up next, the world title will be on the line in a triple threat. Stay tuned. You guys are ready for this? Because I'm certainly ready for this. I've been waiting for this match all week, and now that we have a triple threat on our hands, this is going to get even better. Here comes Joe Crusoe, who had about, I'm tempted to say, about 4 or 5 minutes to get ready for his match right now from the last match. So this man is still, he's taking a beating. Damian definitely put him through some hell in their one-on-one match. That was about a 20-minute match, too. So Joe Crusoe had his work cut out for him to get this match. And he is gonna have a friend in there with Jackson Montgomery, but when it comes to the championship, especially when you're Joe Crusoe, and hopefully when you're Jackson Montgomery, there are no friends in this ring. This is gonna be a war for the World Heavyweight Championship. I can assure you that. With these three guys in here, these three combustible elements, these three guys are just gonna go all out, and I cannot wait to see it happen. I can only imagine what kind of match we're gonna get, because this is a pay-per-view quality main event that you're getting for free on Pulse. And Joe Crusoe, you got to think, trying to work the kinks out with his arm right there. You got to think he's trying to get his body back into fighting shape again. He did have a couple of minutes to rest, like I said, but that's no recuperation time when you got a championship match to prepare for. These guys go into championship matches sometimes have weeks to months to prepare for who they're going to fight. Joe Crusoe had 5 minutes. So it's definitely not in his favor, but he's definitely a resilient competitor in the ring. And here comes Seraph right now. Seraph is looking like the odd man out here, because like I said, Damian is not allowed to interfere in this match. And if Damian had won the match against Joe Crusoe would not have been allowed to interfere in this match. So it could have been very different if we had Damian and Seraph against Jackson. I can almost guarantee you we would have a new champion in that situation. Jackson, he's a great fighter, no doubt about it. He tried to take three guys out on his own a couple of weeks ago. But when you're the only target in a championship match for your title, it's not going to look good. And Joe Crusoe, you got to think, will be on Jackson's side. But he is, he's going to be going after Jackson a fair amount, too. He wants that championship, no doubt about it. And now we only got one man to wait for. The man. The World Heavyweight Champion, Jackson Montgomery. I'm going to let his entrance do the talking. This is a hell of an entrance. That man is happy about it. There he is, the World Heavyweight Champion of Crunchmoo Evolution Wrestling, Jackson Montgomery. The fans love this man, rightfully so. He's a hell of a wrestler, hell of an athlete, and he's going to do whatever he can to not only win every match, but win this match, because he wants that title, and he said it before, he wants to keep that title for his entire career, which would be a hell of an accomplishment, no doubt about it. I don't think that's ever happened before, where one person was champion their entire career. But if anybody could do it, I'm gonna give Jackson Montgomery all the props in the world. He can do it. We could be seeing the new evolution of Bruno Sammartino here get a 7-year title reign. I fully believe Jackson Montgomery, of all people, can do it. When you see Seraph and Joe on the outside of the ring, they're not standing anywhere near each other, because if they're near each other, there's gonna be a brawl breaking out. Thank God Joe Cusso is not attacking Seraph before the belt, because this man is a loose cannon, to say the least. And I can't wait for this belt to start. I'm just getting really antsy with anticipation right here. Here we go. We got to do the opening ceremony. There it is. That's the grand prize this is all for, ladies and gentlemen. The CME World Championship. Ref showing it off to all the wrestlers. Showing it off to all the audience. That's what it's for. Seraph, Joe Cusso, Jackson Montgomery. Here we go. Bell rings. They both went right after Seraph. You got to think, but Jackson goes right after Joe. He's going to show Joe immediately that he is not taking any bullcrap from Joe. Irish whip, but Seraph counters with a jawbreaker of his own. Joe trying to stop the suplex. Jackson counters, and Joe gets some right hands in on the face of Seraph while he's being held by Jackson by the neck. You know what? Joe did get dropkicked by Jackson, but you got to think it's a strategy. You got to get one guy out of here early, get him out of the match, then you got a one-on-one match. That's generally the triple threat strategy, especially when you got an alliance. And Jackson Montgomery is ripping apart the announcer's table, and Seraph gets clotheslined right out of the ring for good measure. Are they going to put him through the table this early? That's one way to get rid of your opponent that you don't like. Just put him through the announce table. I think Jerry... Seraph escaped the clothesline from Jackson on the outside. Did not escape the crossbody from Joe on the inside from the top rope. Jackson's on the top rope here. Went for a double axe handle, but missed. Seraph was out of the way, but they knock him right back down. You got to think, with this alliance between Jackson and Joe Cusso, that if one man, misses a move like that, the other one's going to capitalize right there and come right back on it. And they're double team, double Russian leg sweep from Jackson and Joe. They're working together early on. Even though Joe did get dropkicked, you got to think, like I said, they got to get one man in the match first, and then it's all fair game for Joe. Joe misses the fist drop. Jackson went to capitalize, but he gets back body drop for good measure from Seraph. Joe is up to his feet. Seraph gets Jackson in a headlock with some elbows, and Joe stomps him right in the ribs to break that up pretty quickly. Now they're just measuring Seraph. Seraph is like I said, he's the odd man out right here. He's going to have to fight extra hard to get his title if he wants to win it. Jackson elbows him from the corner. Joe's got him in an electric chair. Electric chair drop from Joe Cusso. And a beautiful springboard moonsault from Jackson. Jackson's going to go for the cover here. But Joe Cusso is not too pleased with that. Breaks it up immediately. And Jackson's going to confront Joe about it. I think they're having some words with each other. And here comes Seraph to try and capitalize on the distraction. Nice snap suplex from Seraph on Jackson Montgomery. And Joe with a brutal clothesline, taking all of his weight into that one, knocking Seraph right back down. Joe's on the top rope here. Beautiful fist drop from Joe. You got to think, Joe's going for the cover here. And Jackson immediately plays the reverse of what Joe did earlier, breaks it up. And Jackson's going right after Joe. He Irish whips Joe onto the apron. But Joe with a straight right to Jackson. This alliance is not looking too good right now, I got to tell you that. And they're fighting. Seraph's just enjoying the scene right here. You got to think he's good with a break, but Jackson goes right after him. Seraph back body drops him again. Joe Cusso going for the attack, but Seraph now elbows right to the top of the head of Jackson. Joe Cusso strangely didn't break that one up. You got to think he's a little bit upset with Jackson right here. A scoop slam almost on top of Jackson Montgomery, but he managed to get out just in time. And Jackson's going for the cover again. And Joe breaks it right up. These two are clearly not on the same page, but they're trying to steal some wins from each other. Nice uppercut from Joe on Jackson. Yeah, this alliance is pretty much broken down. Joe, Irish whip, Jackson. That was incredible. Hit him with a nice handstand springboard diamond cutter, it looked like. Jackson knocks down Seraph for good measure. Went for a nice springboard, but I don't know if he caught him with his feet or if he just missed. Jackson immediately turns his attention to Joe, though, to get back in it. Drop kicks him and then poses right in front of Joe. Joe's like, I'm just going to forget about that and go for Seraph. But Seraph's up to his feet. Irish whips Jackson real hard into the corner. Jackson crumples to the ground. A nice elbow from Seraph into the face of Joe Cusso. This is just fast pace. All three of these guys are going at it from the get-go, and I love every second of it so far. Boots to the face from Seraph on Jackson Montgomery. Joe missed the dropkick. Seraph pushed him out of the way, but Joe hit the punch to the back of the head. Joe pulls him down by the back of his head into his knee, and Jackson's on the top rope to follow that up. Is he going to go for the money shot? He looks like he is. And he hits the money shot. Jackson hits the money shot on Seraph. Well, he's not going for the pin, though. Smart move, because Joe Crusoe was standing right over him. Jackson giving him a little time to play to the crowd. That's his character. That's what he does. Oh, and Joe's going for that sleeper. We saw that multiple times against Damian just before earlier in the show. Jackson breaks it up and then clotheslines Joe down to the mat for good measure. Seraph's going to get out of there. Oh, Jackson goes for the cover. We got a one. Oh, Seraph threw the chair onto the ref to break the count up, but I think Joe kicked out of it anyway. That's one way to break up the count. Hit the ref with a chair. Oh, Jackson kicked Joe in the face, I believe, but it knocked Seraph off of Joe. Jackson's on the top rope. Oh, Joe moved out of the way of that steel chair shot. He's holding the chair shot. Oh, Joe managed to knock the chair back into Seraph's face, but Jackson came off the top rope with a cross body right into Joe. He had no idea what was coming. And Seraph gets thrown out to the apron for good measure. Uh-oh. Oh, Jackson hip tosses him on the inside. The back of his head might have hit that steel chair. Remember, triple threat matches, no disqualification and no countout. Anything goes in a triple threat match. Jackson's propped up that chair right in between the top and the middle turnbuckle here. That could spell at the end for whoever's head gets hit into that. Uh-oh, Jackson's going for that delayed suplex. We saw this before many times. He's doing a little flexing for good measure. Nice, and he drops the vertical suplex on Seraph. Oh, Joe's going for something, but Seraph... Oh, beautiful arm drag, but Jackson caught him right after the arm drag into a springboard elbow, but he felt the brunt of that more than anybody else, I think, as Seraph got picked up right by Joe. Now Joe throws Seraph into the corner. Oh, but Seraph boots his way out of it. Jackson, though, right on top of the game again. He's got that delayed head scissors that we've seen many times to show off with. These two look like they're back on top of Seraph right now, picking him apart like vultures, honestly. Oh, Joe threw Seraph, went to throw him outside of the ring. Jackson came right on top of him with a bulldog just to show Joe that he is not going to be intimidated. He's got a cover on Joe, but Seraph's in there to break it up. He doesn't want to take any chances, though, even though Joe could have possibly kicked out of that bulldog. And now Jackson, they're just dumping Seraph, it looks like, to the apron, trying to keep him free. Seraph, though, is back to his senses and pushes Jackson right off the top rope from the apron. And Joe is on the outside of the ring. I don't know what he's going for. He's almost telling them to get outside the ring. But Jackson and Seraph are going at it one-on-one on the inside of the ring here. Jackson knees him in the gut and throws Seraph to the ground here. Uh-oh, he's calling for that elbow. Boom, Jackson hits a beautiful elbow from the second rope. And, oh, by the way, Joe Crusoe threw a bat into the ring. That's not going to be good for anybody. Uh-oh, Seraph. Oh, no. Oh, Seraph Irish whips Jackson head first into that chair that was propped up in the corner. Jackson just got smashed. And Joe's got another chair of his own right now. Oh, and he runs and hits Seraph in the ribs with it, and then hits him in the legs for good measure. Joe Crusoe has got the advantage. Both of these men are down, and he's got a steel chair. Now he props it up in the corner again, much similar to the one we just saw. Jackson's just getting to his feet. Seraph being helped to his feet. He's definitely taking the brunt of the punishment, Seraph. Uh-oh, Joe just punches him right down to the ring. Oh, and Joe was going to follow Seraph out. Jackson punches him off the apron, and oh my god, Jackson with a springboard senton from the top rope. Joe Crusoe got absolutely crushed by Jackson Montgomery. Oh, but Joe throws Seraph out of the way. Seraph is trying to follow up on that, and Joe is not happy with Jackson. He's going to go after Jackson of his own. He throws him ribs first as hard as he could into the table. Now Joe is picking Jackson up, and Seraph, if I was Seraph, Joe's going for the sleeper hold. If I was Seraph, I would take the time to stay in the ring while these two just tear each other apart. And he's definitely watching. He has no intention of breaking up that sleeper hold for sure. Joe Crusoe tried to get a clothesline in on him. Seraph dumps him into the ring, and Jackson knocks Seraph down with the clothesline to the back of the head. Joe's got a baseball bat now as Jackson dumps Seraph into the corner right in between the steel stairs and the barricade. Jackson posing for everybody. Oh, but he gets a baseball bat to the back of the head. Jackson Montgomery has got to be knocked out cold after that one. Joe is just picking his limp carcass up to his feet. And Joe is throwing Jackson. Joe's got Jackson on the announce table. Seraph is up, but Seraph has no intention of like breaking this up like before. Oh no. Oh, Joe with a step over reverse face crusher. Jackson went right through the table face first. Seraph went to pick him apart, but Joe punched Seraph in the back of the head for good measure. My goodness. Jackson, the champion, is now down. He has got to be down for a good amount of time. He just got face crushed through the announce table, and he's just struggling right now to try and get to his feet. Joe can try to get the pin on Seraph here if he wants to. Jackson is just struggling to his feet right now. I think JBL, Michael, and Jerry can sit down safely because I think they have nothing else to be afraid of. That table's gone. Oh, it's Sarah for the nice elbow to Joe Crusoe in the ring. Jackson just ran and picked up a steel chair from the timekeeper's table, pulling an auto on us from earlier. But this time it's legal, and he hits Sarah in the back with a steel chair and knocks Sarah right down to the ground. Joe Crusoe, oh, Joe gets it right in the ribs of his own. What's Jackson? Jackson's got both men down. He's going for a cover on Joe. We got a one. We got a two. This could be it. Oh, Joe just gets up at two. Almost got a three count off the steel chair. Oh, and Jackson's trying to get Seraph. Seraph is also down. We got a one. We got a, oh, almost a two count. Joe managed to just break it up in time. That was a good strategy from Jackson. If Joe stayed down a little bit longer, we might have had Jackson retain this title. But Jackson gets dumped unceremoniously out of the ring, and now it's back to Joe and Seraph one-on-one in the ring. Nice vertical suplex from Joe. This is looking like any man's ballgame. Joe Crusoe, give him credit, after wrestling that hellacious war against Damian earlier, is looking like the freshest man of the two now. He hasn't taken too much in the way of serious damage. Oh, but he goes for a back suplex. Seraph reverses it into a crossbody of his own. All the Seraph's weight came right down on Joe's head. Jackson, though, springboard, missed the dropkick, though. Seraph was not in the same position. Seraph was going for that electric chair elbow. Oh, my God, how did he hit that? He had no idea where Seraph was. Seraph was down on the ground. Jackson springboarded up to the top rope, hit him with a corkscrew leg drop to the back of Seraph's head. Seraph's face planted in the mat, and he is looking loopy right now. Joe, oh no, Joe's got Jackson in that lawn dart position. Is he going to hit it? Jackson just got lawn darted into the second turnbuckle, and Seraph's trying to steal that win. We got a one. Joe breaks up the pin at one. My God, these three guys, this is four. The CME World Heavyweight title. That's how much this championship means to all three of these guys. And Seraph hits Joe with that neck wrench suplex. Oh, went for an elbow on Jackson, but Jackson with a nice up and over into a back suplex. Beautiful move from Jackson Montgomery. Uh-oh. Nice. That flexing elbow drop. And Joe is up to his feet, though. These two are just teaming a partner right now to take out Seraph, it looks like. Joe's going for a cover, though, and that's clearly not going to work with Jackson standing right over him. I'm starting to think Joe just wants to get in Jackson's head a little bit and make him sweat a little. And look at this. He's doing it again right in front of Jackson. Jackson kicks him in the back of the head. And Jackson's not happy about this for sure. And Joe is getting out of harm's way. But he gets Jackson in an Irish whip. He throws Jackson right out of the ring. This is what Joe needs. But Joe throws Seraph right out of the ring. What is his strategy here? You cannot win the match despite it being no count out, no disqualification. You cannot win this match outside of the ring. You have to pin them or submit them inside. Oh, and Joe is about to take Jackson, his partner, I should say, apart with a chair shot and then dumps the chair right on the back of his head. And now Joe is getting the steel stairs. This man is a lethal weapon when it comes to steel stairs. Oh, and he just levels Seraph with the stairs. We've seen their tables match, Joe and Seraph, those stairs were put to very good use, I will say that. And he hits Seraph down, knocks Jackson down with the stairs, and then jumps the stairs on the ground. This is looking more and more like Joe Crusoe's time. He has the control. He has everything he needs right now to keep the momentum going. And if he can keep it going, we might be looking at our new World Heavyweight Champion, Joe Crusoe. Joe tried to dump the stairs right on Jackson's body, but Jackson managed to get out just at the nick of time and avoid it. That could have definitely crushed him. Oh, Jackson throws Joe Crusoe headfirst into the brick wall that is Seraph, hits him again, and then Jackson's going to get in the ring and get out of here. But Seraph's about to follow him back in. Oh, beautiful catching DDT. Seraph didn't even get to his feet before Jackson planted his head into the mat. Oh, but Joe just got punched in the back of the head for good measure. And then a straight right hand from Jackson. Oh, and Jackson didn't even see Seraph behind him, but must have knew where he was because he hit him with a nice springboard moonsault, knocking Seraph right back down to the ground. But you got to think that took a lot out of Jackson as well. Oh, no. Joe's got Jackson up. He's going to go with an uppercut, and Seraph's certainly not going to stop him. Boom! An uppercut. That's the teeth knockerer. That's not what he calls it, but that's what I'm going to call it. And Seraph catches Joe, throws him face first into the chair in the corner, and he's going for the cover on Joe. We got a one. We got a two. This could be it. Oh, he just kicked out the mat. The hand of the ref almost hit the mat. Seraph could have been the new World Heavyweight Champion. And he chops Joe in the top of the head, going for that vertical suplex. Oh, but Joe counters it into a suplex of his own. Oh, and Jackson's got him with a nice... Oh, that's a beautiful pin cover. We got a one. We got a two. Oh, Joe just kicks out at two. My goodness. I don't know who's going to win this match. This is an excellent match we got so far. This is main event caliber. Joe's got him in the Koji clutch. Just put down Damian before, but Jackson breaks it right up, saying, no, son, you ain't going to get that done in front of me. And Jackson throwing Joe. Oh, he dumps Joe out of the ring. This could be it for Seraph. He's in there alone. Oh, my God. Jackson hit him with the good luck. He hits Seraph with the good luck. Seraph's head is busted wide open. We got a one. We got a two. Joe is out. How did he kick out of the good luck? Oh my God, that was a flipping pile driver. It split Seraph's head wide open and he still kicked out. Gives Seraph all the credit in the world. He's fighting a two-on-one uphill battle and he is still fighting. And he counters that rebound. Oh, but Jackson counters the scoop slam, just hits him in the back of the head. Seraph's taking some serious damage. He hit him and he rebounded right into another Koji clutch. And Jackson breaks it up again. Joe Crusoe is just desperate to try and win this match by any means necessary. Jackson throws Joe against the ropes. Joe not going anywhere, but he gets clotheslined over the ropes for his efforts. My gosh, man. What a war between these three guys. These three are just flat-out warriors. Oh, Jackson knocks him down. Not a big high-impact move, but going for the cover anyway. We got a one. We got a two. Joe Crusoe just gets in the ring to break it up in time. Seraph tried to sit up, but he falls right back down, and he gets his leg wrenched, a knee wrenched for good measure. My God. Jackson's out of the ring trying to get some more toys, trying to get some... catch his breath, honestly. That might be his strategy here. Joe's on the top rope. Oh, Joe! I thought he was going for Seraph, but he jumps on the top rope right on top of Jackson, who had no idea that was coming. And I think Joe might have landed on the chair, too. Oh, my gosh. Seraph is the one getting to his feet right now. So is Joe trying to get up to his feet. But this could be Seraph's time now. He has been persistent. He is bleeding profusely, though. But he is still in this matchup. Oh, and Joe's got stairs, though. That's not... Oh, Seraph just gets out of the ring. And he gets the stairs. Oh, nice Russian leg sweep from Jackson right on that steel chair. My goodness. If the mats weren't thin enough to where it hurts, you have a chair on top of it, that's not good. Oh, no. Oh, he just vertical suplexed Jackson on the remnants of that broken table and almost the stairs he hit, too. Seraph is up to his face. His face is covered in blood. A crimson mask is covering Seraph's face. Oh, he throws Jackson as hard as he could into that steel post and that ring apron. Jackson and Seraph are going at it on the outside. And Joe is on the top rope. What is he going to do? Oh, Joe went for a double axe handle and he missed. But Seraph just threw Jackson up and landed him face first on the barricade. And Joe is going for some punches, but Seraph manages to counter. I think Joe's trying to open that wound up even more. Oh, Seraph throws Joe into the ring, though. This is not looking good for Joe Crusoe. Nice right hand. Beautiful leg screw, dragon screw from Seraph. Jackson's up to his feet, though, after getting thrown on the barricade. We got a one. We got a two. Oh, Jackson just breaks it up in time. Manages to get in the ring and recognize the pin. He almost lost his championship there to Seraph. Multiple times, actually, Jackson has almost lost his championship. Oh, Joe throws Seraph against the ropes. Nice back body drop from Joe, but Jackson right there to pick up Joe's pieces. Throws Joe to the ring apron. Oh, and hip tosses him right back into the ring. Uh-oh, what do we got? Jackson's picking up Joe. Seraph is just sitting up trying to get some life back into him. Beautiful dropkick from Jackson onto Joe. I think the alliance is all but over. These three guys are just going for the win right now. There's no hiding it. They're just going against each other. Uh-oh, Joe was distracting Jackson, and Seraph's got Joe up. He was going for that electric chair drop into the elbow, but Joe punches Seraph right in the face and gets Jackson to sleeper. Seraph gets Joe in a Russian leg sweep, and we're all at it again. Back and forth, back and forth. Beautiful springboard from Jackson, but gets clotheslined before he can even get it to his feet from Seraph. Holy cow, I don't know how I'm not out of breath from this. This is amazing. This is an amazing match to call. And I'm really glad we could bring it to you tonight here on Pulse. This is excellent stuff. This is what CME is all about. This is what Pulse is all about. This is what the World Heavyweight Championship is all about. And if you're not liking what you're seeing right now, you got to check your pulse, honestly, because this is wrestling. This is real wrestling. And Joe Crusoe gets Seraph. Looked like he was setting him up for the sleeper hold, but Seraph manages to just get out of it. Joe is going to divert his attention to Jackson. Oh, beautiful clothesline from Joe Crusoe, knocking Jackson right down. I thought we were going to have an alliance there between Seraph and Joe, honestly, but Joe takes Seraph down for good measure. I don't know if I'll ever see Joe and Seraph in an alliance, but stranger things can happen. And Jackson's trying to get to his feet. Joe forces him up to his feet. What do we got here? Oh, Joe is just placing Jackson's limp body onto the ring ropes. He was going for something. He was measuring something, but Seraph snuck up right from behind and hit Joe with a back suplex. Uh-oh. Is he going to dump Jackson out of the ring? Yes, he is. He throws Jackson out of the ring. Seraph could go for the pin here if he wants to. Seraph is going for the pin on Joe. We could have a new champ. We got a one. We got a two. Oh, Joe just kicked out at two. Oh, my God. I was picturing a world heavyweight champion in Seraph right there. I was picturing Seraph coming up to the title. I thought he had it right there. Seraph brings a sledgehammer in the ring, gets knocked down for his effort, and his limp body fell across the ropes. And now Joe hits him with a sledgehammer right in the back. Jackson's in the ring. Joe drops the sledgehammer, but Jackson Irish whips Joe into the corner. My gosh. Oh, what do we got here? Jackson, Seraph's down. He's down for the count. And Jackson is going for the flexed elbow drop, but Joe is up to his feet here. Uh-oh, they're both going after Seraph again. Uh-oh, he's going to go for that uppercut? Yep, he is, and Jackson's stepping back. He wants to see this unfold. Boom, Seraph just got uppercutted right in the mouth, and Jackson, once again, no rest for the weary. You hit one move, he's right on you, and Jackson, he dumps Joe right out to the outside. Oh, Joe hit the stairs on his way out there. Jackson's measuring something. Oh, my God, no. Oh, the suicide somersault sent on Joe. The back of Joe's head just hit that baseball bat. Oh, my God. Oh, look at the back of his head collide with that bat. All of Jackson's weight just presses it right down, and Joe could be out. This is now down to Jackson and Seraph. Seraph is going to chase Joe outside the ring. He's not going for Jackson. He wants to take out Joe Crusoe. I think this is just revenge, and he gets thrown into the ring for good measure. How is Joe alive? Like, how is his head not bleeding? I don't even understand it. Oh, what do we got here? Jackson's going to swing him. He's doing the giant swing. Oh, I thought he was going to throw him on that sledgehammer. He almost did. Oh, no. Joe was picking up that sledgehammer, but Jackson had no intention of letting Joe use it on him. Uh-oh. Oh, my gosh. Shoulder first goes Joe Crusoe right into the ring post. What do we got here? What do we got here? Oh, no. Jackson's going for it. Is he hit it? Yes, he is. He hits a good night on Seraph. This could be it, but Joe is up to his feet. Joe is up to his feet, and Jackson, he cannot pin him. Yeah, he cannot pin Seraph after the good night because Joe was right there. If he did it, he would have broke it up. Oh, here it goes, though. He's got Joe incapacitated in the corner. He's got a pin. Oh, but his hand was under the ropes. We saw that earlier in the Damian Joe Crusoe match. Seraph could not kick out of it. I don't think he even knew where he was, but his hand was underneath the bottom rope. And Seraph is just trying to pull him up. Oh, my. Did he land on the sledgehammer? Seraph's face landed face first on the hammer from that suplex. We got a one. We got a two. We got a three. Jackson Montgomery retains his title after an up and over reverse suplex. Seraph's head face first on the sledgehammer. Oh, my God. What a match. What a triple threat title match we just saw between three guys who would not give an inch. And we got to see every highlight we can, because holy cow, I cannot believe what I just had the privilege of calling for you people. I hope it was as good for you as it was for me, because I think I need a cigarette after that match. Wow. What a match. Take nothing away from Joe Crusoe, from Seraph, especially from Jackson, since he won the match. Jackson won a hard-fought match, but he earned it. Joe Crusoe wrestled a 20-minute match earlier in the show and still put up the fight of his life for this championship. Seraph kicked out of the good luck, got his head split wide open from the good luck, and he kicked out. Give Seraph all the credit in the world, too. But Jackson Montgomery is still your CME World Heavyweight Champion, and if things go along to his plan, he will be your World Heavyweight Champion for a long time to come. And if we get matches like this from Jackson Montgomery's title reign, I'm all for it. He can keep the title for however long he wants if we can get main events on Pulse and on pay-per-view like this. And we'll see the ending right here. Look at this. Face first, Seraph went right on the top of that sledgehammer. It was all academic from there. Jackson Montgomery gets the three count, keeps the championship. And you got to think, after a war like that, Jackson and Joe Crusoe now, in a couple of weeks, 13 days to be exact, have to team up to fight Seraph and Damian as Jackson gets his championship. After that kind of match, you gotta think how their relationship is. It's gotta be fractured. It was fractured from the start. It's gotta be even more fractured right now. We see Jackson celebrating. Come back next week, ladies and gentlemen. Have a good night.